Okay, ito na yung part 4 of our discussion about fundamentals of criminal investigation. So, tapos na tayo sa phase 1, which is the identification of criminal. We will proceed naman sa tracing, locating, and apprehending the criminals. So, if an investigator na-identify na kung sino yung suspect, so, we'll proceed to the tracing. So, gamit ang informant, we will locate or trace the criminal. So, ito yung informant. Kung sa mga terms pa ito na ginagamit ng mga police or ng mga law enforcement, ito yung tinatawag nilang alpha. So, ito yung informant. Informant is a person who gives information to the police relevant to a criminal case about the activities of criminals or syndicates. So, usually, itong mga informant, ito yung mga nag-i-inform, nagbibigay ng information sa police about the suspect. Diba? Para matrace nila, para matrace ng mga police or ng mga law enforcement agencies kung saan palaging pumupunta yung suspect. Ito yung mga informants. Then, may types of informant tayo. First, itong anonymous informant. Diba? Rival elimination informant. Then, the false informant. The frightened informant. Self-aggrandizing informant. The mercenary informant. The double crosser. The woman informant. And the legitimate informant. So, when we talk about anonymous informant, ito yung mga informant na hindi nagbibigay ng kanilang mga pangalan. So, nagbibigay lamang sila ng information without giving this their identity. Diba? Ito yung anonymous informant, from the word anonymous. So, rival elimination informant, ito yung informant na in order to eliminate their competition or yung mga rival nila. Ginagawa nila is nabibigay sila ng information sa police about the activity of their rival. So, usually ito yung mga gumagawa din ng mga illegal. Yung motive lamang nila nito is to eliminate the competition. So, sila yung mas maraming kita, di ba? Through their illegal activities. So, false informant reveals information of no consequence or value. So, ito yung mga informants na nagbigay ng information but in the bottom line. So, hindi rin wala ding value. So, maraming ganitong mga alpha or mga informants. When I was assigned in intelligence, di ba? So, may mga alpha or informants kami na they are giving information in order lamang for monetary reasons or mabigyan sila ng reward, but yung information na is walang value. So, ito yun. So, frightened informant, motivated by anxiety. Ito yung mga taong in-inform nila yung illegal activities sa mga police because they motivated by anxiety or natatakot pa sila. Di ba? So, self-aggrandizing. Ano itong self-aggrandizing informant? Talks about the fringe of the criminals. So, when we talk about aggrandizing, so, ito yung mga informants na mga pabida or ito yung mga informants na gusto nila sila lang yung pansinin. So, ito yung self-aggrandizing. Parang gusto nilang ma-focus sa kanila yung attention ng mga pulis natin. So, ito yung mga self-aggrandizing. So, kung magbibigay sila ng information, so, ako ang mas magaling, di ba? So, ito yung self-aggrandizing. Parang, kung sa Bisaya pa is kapayasun. Ito yung mga informant nito. Then, the mercenary informant. Give information for a price. So, meaning, ito yung mga nagbibigay ng information for a reward, di ba? Gusto nilang, for example, bigyan sila ng pera ng mga pulis natin. So, ito yun. The double crosser informant. So, ito yung delikado. Double crosser informant. Kasi, they are informing the police or they are giving the information for them, for the benefits of them na malaman ano yung mga information na nandoon din sa mga police. So, for example, pumasok siyang informant. Then, in order for him to protect his illegal activities, so, para malaman yung mga magalaw ng mga police natin, so, or mga law enforcement agencies, so, pumasok sa informant. So, ito yung delikado, yung double crosser informant. So, woman informant. So, alam naman natin na mas magbibigay ng maraming information yung mga illegal mga yung mga criminal by using a woman informant. So ito yung mga babaeng nagbibigay ng information. So it is the female associate of the criminals. So, meaning mas pinagkakatiwalaan ng mga criminal itong mga babae kaysa mga lalaki. So ito yung woman informant. It is the best informant din para sa mga police natin. So legitimate informant, it is the operators of legitimate business establishment. So, meaning nag-inform sila to, in order for them to protect their businesses. So may legal business sila in order for them to protect their business. So nagre-report sila sa mga illegal na ginagawa ng mga kriminal, di ba? So ito yung legitimate informant. So surveillance, when we talk about surveillance, so ang kwan kasi yung fundamentals of criminal investigation, it involves the works of the intelligence. So in order to trace and locate the criminal and to apprehend the criminal, so we need to have a surveillance. So ito yung intelligence works ng police or yung intelligence mechanism. So it is, when we talk about surveillance, it is the secret observation of persons, places, and vehicles. So tatlong yan. Ino-observe yung tao, mga bagay, or yung vehicles, or yung place, for the purpose of obtaining information concerning the identities or the activities of the subject. So ito yung surveillance. The kinds of surveillance, may surveillance of place tayo or yung tinatawag nila fixed surveillance or stick out surveillance. May surveillance tayo na tinatawag na tailing or shadowing. Then ito yung then next is roping or undercover investigation. So when we talk about tailing or shadowing, ito yung nagpa-follow talaga sila sa mga moving subject or mga person. So ito yung tailing or shadowing. Then itong roping or undercover investigation, nagpe-pretend sila into another personalities or other character na nakikita sa environment for them to gather information about the subject. So ito yung undercover investigation. So, ito yon. Then, surveillance. When we talk about surveillance, ito yung mga tao who maintains the surveillance or perform the observation. So, when we talk about surveillance, inti, ang last, ito yung mga tao. Surveillance, ito yung ginagawa or activity ng intelligence operation. Subject, the person or place being watched or surveyed. How to conduct surveillance of place. So, ito yung mga ginagawa. A careful survey of the surrounding area should be made. So, the character of the neighborhood, residents, and transient should be noted. So, ito, anong mga ginagawa ng mga tao na nandyan sa area. Then, the observation point should be selected properly. So, then, when observation is conducted from plant, surveillance agents must be extremely careful not to reveal their true activity. Then, observation may be made through a window or other aperture so as to be unnoticed from the outside. So, usually, ginagamit nila dito is yung mga tinted cars para hindi sila makita. Ito yung ginagamit ng mga intelligence officer natin to gather information. Then, Venetian blinds afford the best coverage, but may appear to be out of place of some buildings. So, ito yung mga hindi nakikita ng mga area. So, mas appropriate area yung mga blind area or ito yung hindi makikita na mas madali, di ba? Ito yung mga area. So, mas appropriate ito for surveillance para hindi malaman ng mga subject ang ginagawa ng mga intelligence officer natin. An alternative is lower the ruler of draw shades another inch from the window. So, we can use the binoculars are generally essentially equipment of the plants, di ba? A still or video camera with telephoto lens can also be used effectively. So, ito na itong magamit natin ito yung mga gadgets. So, in order to identify yung mga subject natin. Agents should take careful notes of what they observe and should record detailed descriptions of all individuals entering the target. So, sino yung mga nag-enter or nag-exit sa area na ginagamitan ng surveillance, di ba? So, kailangan ma-apply din natin itong 5 W's and 1 H nito. So, in order for them to have a detailed descriptions of the subject, di ba? A chronological log is usually the best recording pertinent occurrences. So, methods of shadowing. May tinatawag tayong 1-man, 2-man ABC method, progressive leap frame method, then the combined foot auto surveillance. When we talk about 1-man, extremely difficult and should be avoided. If available, keep subject in views at all times. So, when we talk about 1-man, yung nagsusurveillance or yung mga surveillant is, kuha naman siya. Siya lamang isa na nag-observe sa subject. When we talk about 2-man, dalawang agents ng ang gumagawa ng activity na ito. Then, ABC method, tatlong person yung gumagawa ng surveillance operation. Then, the progressive leap-frame method. Poor chances of obtaining good results. Agents are stationed at fixed point assuming that the subject are following the same general route each day. So, mas mahirap ito kasi kung sa Bisaya pa, ambak-ambak. So, nag-observe siya from fixed point. Then, pupunta na naman siya sa another fixed point. So, ang basihan nitong surveillance na ito is the route of the subject in everyday, di ba? Everyday routine niya. So, mas mahirap ito kasi hindi natin malalaman kung doon ba siya pumupunta talaga, di ba? Combined foot auto surveillance, employment of surveillance on foot and agents in an automobile. May naglakad, mayroon ding doon sa car mismo nag-observe. So, ito yung combined foot auto surveillance. So, what are the things that should be avoided during shadowing? So, ito yung in-avoid during the conduct of the tailing or shadowing. Don't meet the eye of the subject. So, ito yung pinakapit natin. Huwag mong direktang tingnan yung mata ng subject mo. Kasi baka mapaibig out. Hindi. Baka malaman niya na inu-observe siya at yung mga galaw niya, di ba? So, don't adapt a slinking, sluting, creeping manner. So, ito. Then, don't wear storybook disguises. So, anong ibig sabihin nito? Huwag kang magsuot ng mga dress na kadalasang ginagamit sa mga fictional books. So, ito yung mga number one error ng mga nagkakandak ng surveillance. Ay, di magpapanggap sila na isa silang kuan, isang pulubi. So, bawal yan. So, don't do that when conducting surveillance. Kasi, parang madali lang malaman kung nagkakandak ka ba talaga ng surveillance o wala. So, ito yung kailangan i-avoid. Then, don't carry noticeable items. So, ano yung mga noticeable items? Yung mga makukulay ang damit or yung mga may dalakang bag na ma-observe directly ng subject. So, avoid natin yan. Diba? Don't greet fellow agents. So, number one rule, one of the rule, huwag mong batiin yung fellow agents mo. Diba? Don't make notations ostensibly. So, ito yung pinakalas. Then, how to detect foot surveillance. A subject who is suspicious of being under surveillance may resort to trickery in order to verify his suspicion. Diba? When a subject resort to such trickery, it is good policy to change agents. So, ito yun. Pag na-observe niya na sinusundan siya or sinusurveillance siya, then try to change or try to change agents. Oh. So, palitan yung agents na nagsusubilan. So, in order to para mawala yung suspicion ng subject. Stopping abruptly and look back, casually looking around. Then, reversing course, retracing steps. Ito yun. Ito yung mga maditik mo na sinusurveillance ka. Then, boarding bus and alighting just before the start. Diba? Then, riding short distance on bus. Siyempre. Diba? Circling the block on a taxi. Then, entering a building and leaving immediately via another exit. So, ganyan yung mga malaman muna sinusurveillance ka. Then, stopping abruptly after turning a corner using convoys. So, ito. Watching reflection in shop windows. So, walking slowly and rapidly at alternative intervals. Dropping a piece of papers to see if anyone retrieves it. So, ganyan. Ganyan yung mga ginagawa ng mga surveillant. Diba? Stopping to tie a shoestring. Oh. Meanwhile, looking around for surveillance. So, ganyan. Yung mga ginagawa. Arranging with a friend in a shop, stores, or other places to watch for surveillance. So, ganyan yan. These are the thing that in order for you to detect foot surveillance. How to elude foot surveillance? Common method to elude surveillance or makaka-escape ka while you are in the foot surveillance in which common method load for surveillance in which surveillance must be prepared and guard against the following: jumping off a bus, diba? Trains just as the doors are about to close and leaving a building through the rear or side exits. So, huwag kang pupunta doon sa the main entrance, diba? Losing oneself in crowds. So, ganito. Pumunta ka sa mas mataong lugar, diba? Entering theaters and leaving immediately through an exit, diba? Pumunta ka sa mga sinihan, then mag-leave ka through exit, diba? Hindi na ka hindi ka na niya makikita niyan or ma-observe. Then, pointing out on one surveillance to police to generally require the agent to explain his action. Then, use decoys. Ito yung mga ginagamit, using decoys. Taking the last taxi at a stand, then changing clothing. So, ito yung how to elude for surveillance. So, understandable naman siguro to. So, automobile surveillance. The methods of auto surveillance to use depends upon the numbers and types of surveillance vehicles available. So, the volume of vehicular traffic in the area. So, kailangan natin malaman yan. Then, the importance of concealing the surveillance from the subject. Diba? Subject's estimated ability to detect and elude surveillance. So, at all times, each vehicle should be occupied by at least two agents. So, kailangan, it is a must. Kailangan dalawa if you are using an automobile surveillance. Kasi yung isa magde-drive at yung isa is mag-observe and will be taking notes. Diba? How to detect automobile surveillance? As in the case of surveillance, a subject who believes he is being followed may resort to trickery in order to verify his suspicions. Some of the common tricks employed is the alternate fast and slow driving. Ito yun. Driving into dead-end streets. So, ito yung mga ginagawa sa mga automobile surveillance, di ba? Frequency parking. Bakit magpapark, di ba? It's a logical common sense. Bakit parati siyang nagpapark? Anong ginagawa niya dyan, di ba? Then, committing flagrant traffic on a way street and running through red lights. Stopping suddenly around curves or corners, di ba? Pulling into driveways. Speeding up a hill. Then, coasting slowly down. So, ito yung mga paraan, how to detect automobile surveillance. So, dito naman tayo how to elude or to escape from automobile surveillance. Then, pinakauna is to commit traffic violations. So, in this way, hindi ka na niya i-surveillance, di ba? Using double entrances to driveways in one and out of the other. Then, curving through parking lots. Driving through congested areas, then deserting the vehicles behind curves of corners, but permitting the drivers to drive on as a decoy. So, ito yun, how to elude automobile surveillance. So, proceed tayo sa undercover investigation. Kaya nang sinabi ko kanina, a form of investigation in which the investigator assumes a different and unofficial identity. So, nagpipretend siya in order to obtain information. So, definition nito is the undercover. An investigative technique in which the agent's investigator's official identity is concealed. So, meaning yung personal identity niya is concealed, tinago to accomplish an investigative mission. Next is the natural cover, using the individual's true identity, occupation, or profession. So, ito yung ginagamit na yung true identity niya. Natural cover. Then, artificial cover. The manufacture of documents, false documents, passport, or forged documents. So, artificial. So, punta tayo dito sa arrest. So, Tapos na tayo sa intelligence mechanism ng investigation to sa second phase ng criminal investigation, which is the tracing, locating, and apprehending the criminals. So dito naman tayo sa last, arresting, oh, di ba? So na-identify na natin, na-locate na natin kung saan siya o saan area sa pumunta o yung mga activities niya. Then proceed naman tayo dito sa arrest. So arrest is the taking of a person into custody in order that he may be bound to answer for the commission of the offense. So ito yung legal definition ng arrest. So forms of arrest: either by actual restraint of a person to be arrested or by his submission to the custody of the person making the arrest. So may two forms lang of arrest: actual restraint or of the person or his submission. No violence or unnecessary force shall be used in making an arrest. So ito yung nasa standard operating procedure sa rules of procedure sa rules of court, di ba? So upon arresting a person, there should no unnecessary force, di ba? A person arrested shall not be subject to a greater extent than is necessary for his detention. So reasonable force lang ang pwede, di ba? Duty of arresting officer: it shall be the duty of the officer executing the warrant to arrest the accused and to deliver him to the nearest police station, then or jail without unnecessary delay. So anong ipinipahiwatig nito? So in order to avoid a case, para hindi makasuhan ang mga police natin, so it shall be the duty of the police officer to bring the arrested person into proper judicial authority upang hindi siya makasuhan ng Article 125, di ba? Ito yung delay into the delivery of the person into proper judicial authority. Nandun yun sa Revised Penal Code, yung delay, di ba? Then, the execution of the warrant: the head of the office to whom the warrant of arrest was delivered for execution shall cause the warrant to be executed within 10 days lamang, di ba? From its receipt. Then, within the 10 days of expiration of the period, the officer to whom it was assigned for execution shall make a report to the judge who issued the warrant. So, may expiration din ito. Hindi yung expiration ng warrant, but the expiration of the period of 10 days. So, i-renew ito ng ng warrant officer. Then, it will di ba? It will make a report to the judge who issued the warrant. Then, in case of his failure to execute the warrant, he shall state the reasons therefore. So, ito yun. Klarong-klaro. Arrest without a warrant when lawful. So, ito yung warrantless arrest. A peace officer or private person may, without a warrant, arrest a person when in his presence the person to be arrested has committed. So, ito lang ha. Has committed, is actually committing, or is attempting to commit an offense. So, ito yung mahulog ito sa in flagrante delicto or caught in the act. Excuse. Then, the second is when an offense has just been committed. So, bago lang na-commit. Then, he has probable cause to believe that based on personal knowledge, kailangan may personal knowledge of facts or circumstances that the person he's arrested was committed. So, ang keyword nito is personal knowledge. Bago lang na-commit, then has a personal knowledge mismo, di ba? So, another term nito is the hot pursuit. The third is when the person to be arrested is a prisoner. was escaped from a penal establishment or place where he is serving final judgment. So ito yung mga escapee or nakatakas galing sa jail or prison, di ba? So ito yung mga requisites to a valid unlawful warrantless arrest. So tapos na tayo sa the fourth part sa ating fundamental criminal investigation. So